drug prize was declined on February 4th, 2020. A transaction of $20.19 approved on January 30th, 2020. A transaction of... If you would like to speak with a Wells Fargo representative about these transactions, say banker or press 0.
Banker.
Please hold while I connect you with a banker who can help you. All of our bankers are busy assisting other callers.
It's terrible music. On hold with Wells Fargo because I woke up to calls and emails that someone used my debit. Someone used my debit card. Shut up, Wells Fargo. To spend $130 at Amazon Prime or at Amazon with Amazon Prime, and it said it was manually entered. I feel like I saw something about Massachusetts. I don't know. We'll see. Wasn't me. It was literally February 4th, which is today. So it was like this morning. But if it was in Massachusetts, I don't know. It just makes no sense. Someone got my card number, which, like, this is why I don't use my debit card to get gas. We'll see if I can figure out who it was or what happened. Also, that is so loud. My couch came, and it's outside, but I'm waiting to bring it inside until I can figure this shit out. So, I also have a few things to tell you guys. So, also, I think this is a new vlog, so hello, welcome to the vlog. Starting on a great note.
For the delay. Currently, we are experiencing an unusually high call volume.
I say that every time. Like, they're always experiencing an unusual call volume. Like, isn't that usual then? Thank you, you too. I want to figure out, I don't think I could contact Amazon because there's no, like, order number, you know? Guess we'll contact Amazon. Maybe I'll go bring my sofa in while I wait for Arun to write to me. This is heavy. What am I trying to do? Fuck. Oh my. It's fucking 92 pounds. Okay, well. Got it inside, that's the first step. Ow! Got the couch inside, I'm now chatting with this dude. I don't know if he can help me, but he asked me if I knew the order number. Obviously not. Okay, so it's the next day since I last vlogged, and poop almost fell off her stool because she was falling asleep. I was trying to put together the sofa yesterday. It says it's 15-minute assembly, but it literally doesn't fit together. So I'm gonna take a second shot at it again today. I was getting so frustrated yesterday for like an hour. I can't tell if like the pieces are put together wrong, the ones that they sent me, so then I can't put them together correctly. Basically, you have to attach this middle thing to both of the arms, and you're supposed to like slide the thingy. You're supposed to slide this into this, but it's like facing the wrong way, so I'm like, do I need to like take this out? And like, I don't know. I was trying for so long and it just kept falling, so I just want to put my couch together, like, Also, I got a box from Thrive Market yesterday, so I'll show you guys that. After I attempt my sofa, which was supposed to be done yesterday, and then I was going to mount my TV today, but it's fine. I should probably buy a stud finder anyway. I downloaded the stud finding app on my phone, so I'm going to try that first. I don't see how that could work, but, I mean, I'm going to try it because it's free. But first, take two at this couch because it's really fucking frustrating, man.
Can do that. I guess you need two people to assemble this, but oh my gosh, I did it. Is it all the way in? I guess it's just not very stable, but I guess that's just I was trying to do that for so long yesterday and it wasn't fitting. Seems okay, whatever. I keep saying both sides must be inserted at the same time. This step is best performed with two people on every single. Well, I only have one people, okay? Okay. Here. Oh gosh. Oh no, I'm stuck. Oh. God damn. Does this fit? Oh, this thing is in the way. Best performed with two people, my butt. Well, actually, yeah. Okay, wait. Something is wrong here with the angle. Am I putting all of my weight on it right now? I mean, it's not gonna fall apart, you know? I don't know what I'm supposed to do with this, it doesn't say. It doesn't stick back here, so I'm not sure what they think I'm supposed to do with this. It doesn't stick. Or does it not do this? Okay, I don't fucking know, but we're gonna skip that. Secure the fabric fabric flap on sofa back to the left and right arms. But that's, isn't that on backwards? Uh-oh. Oh no. Why did it go in then? It went in. Uh-oh, I hope it's gonna come out now. Uh-oh. You might be stuck like this. Oh, okay, okay, okay. I pushed this side in really hard. Okay, so apparently it goes like this. Well, they shouldn't have made it fit both ways. Okay, that wasn't so bad. I guess that makes sense because then the back of it's pretty, but it's going up against a wall, so. Okay. Are you still with me here? Okay, good. I know I'm pale. I'm gonna get a spray tan after this, okay? Shut up. Oh, I'm gonna have a couch! And it matches my ottoman, which I didn't think it would, but it does. So I kind of have a sectional, really. Like a mini sectional. That's exciting. Oh my goodness.
Do not scratch it. She just jumped up there to check it out and is already scratching it, so.
Oh my goodness. But also, the ottoman's right here. I feel like, do I leave it here? Or do I put it in front of that as like a little mini section? Oh my gosh, it looks so much more homey in here. I don't know where to put these blankets. I guess they could fit under the couch, which might make sense. I need like one of those towel racks for blankets. I guess it's probably called a blanket rack.
I hate having Bug's stuff like out right there, like her scratch thingy and her toy. I mean, she has to have her stuff out, you know? I guess I could put it like over here somewhere, but eh. I think it looks so much more homey. It honestly kind of makes my space feel bigger for some reason. Okay, the blankets under there don't look good, huh? I'll have to figure something else out for that, because I don't know. I guess I could fold all of them and put them on the ottoman. I guess that would work. It's weird how I could only really tell that by looking at my glove camera.
Oh, jeez, a bug was attached to that. Where do you keep your blankets? Comment below. Like, that's a little excessive, I feel.
I mean, that seems excessive, no? I'll figure out somewhere else to put those. But wow, I was scared that the sofa wasn't going to match the ottoman, and I mean, the ottoman's a little lighter and they have different colored legs, but I don't really fucking care that much, especially because the legs match the legs of my chair. And then I have this freaking blanket on my bed. But you guys, I mean, isn't it looking so much cuter in here? I mean, there's still stuff, like I still have to do the wallpaper situation. Oh, hi. I haven't even showed you guys in my bathroom yet, I don't think. So that'll be a nice reveal. Okay, well, let's try sitting in it because that's important, right?
I want it to be comfy. It feels pretty firm, I'm not going to lie. Which is weird because all the reviews said it was a super comfy couch. Oh, no, it's comfy for sure. Oh, fuck yeah. Okay, I can get used to this. It makes it look so much cuter. Like, I'm so proud of my space right now. It's not even fully done. You know, the TV's not mounted right now. Like, it's not super tidy. It is, actually. It's pretty freaking spick and span in here. Except for that box of Thrive Market stuff, which I need to put away. But it's just so cute in here. Like, it makes me so happy. It's such a cute little space. Yeah, I didn't think I would get a... Like, I was looking at pink couches. I was looking at yellow couches, like mustard yellow, to match, like, the accents on my pillows. But I feel like this is perfect. And, like, I have a duvet, and I usually just get new duvet covers because I get bored of my duvet. So, like, if I got a different color duvet, I could get, like, a white one, and it would still match this, you know? Anyway, I just think it's so cute in here. I know you guys have been, like, seeing me put it together, but once everything is done, I'll do, like, the actual tour where I kind of go through everything and show you my bathroom, which I haven't done. Yeah. Okay, well, I like this couch. All right. Well, I'll show you what I got from Thrive. I don't know why. It's not really that exciting, actually. Maybe not. Basically, I just made an order at Thrive Market. Not sponsored, not affiliate. Wanted to get nutritional yeast for cheaper, so I made, like, a big order there. It's not that exciting.
They have a lot of vegan snacks, so I got a lot of those. Some coffee creamer. Some of it I already tried and put away, but, like, vegan parmesan. I tried these chickpeas. Probably just put this away, honestly.
I got these little gold nuggets. Gold garlic nuggets? I don't know, but they looked fucking good. I love garlic, man. What's in my fridge? Just kidding. Hop out. I'm gonna close that. Hop out. Hop out. Come on, get out of the fridge. Freaking weirdo. She knows I'm in the kitchen, so she's like, do I get the T-R-E-A-T? Sent me a sample of hemp gummies. You want a treat? There you go. If you have a cat, these are like crack. I don't recommend them because I always get her natural. She's always eating like natural, organic, like good quality food. And then like I got these one time. They're catnip fever temptations. And now she's food driven and she wants these all the time. So probably don't recommend those actually. Sweet potato puffs. Butter flavored popcorn, but it's vegan. I got Earth Balance vegan cheddar squares. I feel like the camera is focusing. Let's bring you over here. Earth Balance vegan flavored, vegan cheddar flavor squares, which are supposed to be like Cheez-Its. They don't really taste like Cheez-Its, but they're good. I really like these popcorners chips. I don't know why I'm showing you my pantry right now. My sister got me these and they're really good. They're tortilla chips, vegan rockin' ranch. So yeah. We have blue corn tortilla chips because I love chips and salsa. Chad got me these organic gummy cubs. They're gummy bears, but they're vegan. They're actually really good. You're in the way. I got these off of Thrive. I got two bags of them. I tried them last night. Don't like them. Didn't realize what they were made out of. They're like vegan barbecue chips, but they're made out of yucca, mushroom, sunflower oil, spice, onion, and sea salt. And I don't know if I like yucca, but I know I don't like mushrooms. And there is like a mushroomy undertone to these, so I'm really not a big fan. Isn't yucca like a root? Yeah, I tried them last night. Oh my god, these are so good. Literally run to your store and get these. Funyuns, but actually it says they're high protein. I did not even know that. I just knew they were vegan. They're called pitos. And they're better than Funyuns because they actually taste like oniony. And they're vegan and apparently they're high protein. 4 grams of protein, which is high for like a snack like this, you know? So good though, like they are so fucking good. I have so many good snacks right now. Ugh. Lesser Evil butter flavored coconut oil and Himalayan salt popcorn. I have so much popcorn, you guys. Got sweet potato puffs, vegan cheesy cheddar. I haven't tried these. Growing up, my mom, I mean, she still does. At my parents' house, they have like so many snack cupboards of just like so many different crackers and chips and nuts, and like it, like every time my friends would come over, they would go over to our snack cupboard. Same with like candy. Like my parents always have so much food, and I was always like, why do we have this many snacks? Like I just want Cheez-Its. But now I kind of understand, you know. I got these I Heart Quinoa
quinoa puffs, sea salt truffle. Never tried them, but got them from Thrive. They have 5 grams of plant protein. They had really good reviews, actually, so I think that's why I got them. And then I never knew that this... Oh, bug. I never knew that this was a thing. I've always thought, like, if we have popcorn, why don't we pop more things, you know? Like, why don't we have, like, popped peas? Or popped... Is corn the only thing that pops like that? I don't know. But I found these, and they're called water lily pops. Himalayan pink salt. And there's 6 grams of protein. Vegan. But apparently, it's just popped water lily seeds, palm oil, and Himalayan pink salt. What are water lily seeds? I mean, I know what they are, just because it sounds pretty self-explanatory. But how come I didn't know that you could, like... pop them and they would look like that. It's probably good for me if it tastes like popcorn because I eat so much corn. Like, I am corn at this point. I am corn, you know? So I don't know, we'll see. Water lily seeds, like so random. I wonder if that's like a new discovery. Then I got these, I've tried this brand's cauliflower, like a dupe of goldfish, and they're really, really good actually. These are butternut squash crackers. But they're Parmesan flavored and vegan. And all the reviews said they taste like Cheez-Its. Made with butternut squash, cassava, potato starch, rice flour, potato flakes, cauliflower, pepper. Yeah, so anyway, that's my little Thrive haul. What else did I get? I also got nutritional yeast. Got these little garlic nuggets, which is so bomb. It's gonna be bomb to put on my popcorn with my nutritional yeast. Hello. And then this, I guess, was a sample. 10 milligrams plant-based. Oh, they're hemp extract infused gummies. Oh, and melatonin. Okay, they're for sleep. Gotcha. I'm gonna take care of this.
A coupon or like a free Chick-fil-A french fry, but then you look at the fine print, it's not free.